Greetings of the day. I am Dr. Renu. First of all, before starting my session, I would like to request you all to subscribe my channel HR Session. My agenda of this session is to provide you the quality education. In the HR Sessions channel, I am going to cover the law subject, industrial relation law, organization behavior, and human resource management. Please like and subscribe my channel and also inform me the improvements or the modifications required or any other topic required at your end. Organization behavior. The organization behavior. What is actually the organization behavior? So before initiating to that, it is very important to understand organization plus behavior. The behavior means the attitude, ability, skill, knowledge. It includes number of things which are the part of the behavior required to be considered to get the work done, as well as to get not only to get the work done but also to get our achievement of the goals. This is very important to be considered and to be controlled. In case of the organization, so what is that too, that I am going to explain. But first of all, in brief, the organization behavior. The organization behavior means the human behavior, which is very important in the organization, as in the organizations, without controlling the behavior of the individuals, it is very difficult to understand what it is, how it is to be handled. Without the behavior, it is difficult to get the activities done and to get the achievement of the main goal of organization. No doubt, organizations being described as clock works in which the human behavior is logical, rational, but they often seems like, you know, snake pit to those who work in them. So it is very important. The snake pit means it simply conveys you the daily conflicts, your struggle, distress in the organization, which a manager is required to control. Each metaphor reflects the reality from different perspectives and the organization into the organization, and even to the individual to the organization point of view. So that's why this is very important to understand, and otherwise it is the individual behavior and the group dynamics. Until and unless it is not there, it is very difficult to get the attainment of the goal of the organization. So the study of the organization behavior is primarily concerned with psychological, interpersonal, behavioral dynamics in an organization, and the various variables of the organization that affect the human behavior at work also relevant to the study of the organization behavior. So what are the organization variables that I will discuss in the another slides. Now, organization behavior, as I told you what it is. Now let us understand what is actually the organization, where the set of the activities are there and set of people are there who are going to perform the task in an organization. Basically, the set of activities grouped together at one place, and when those set of activities grouped together at the different places, though are said in the departments, for example, finance activities, marketing activities, HR activities, when they are grouped in the different smaller groups and the same activities are performed at one place, so that is said to be the departments. And when all the all integrated and the interpersonal and the intra congruency among them is there, then that becomes a whole organization. And no doubt, when each set of the this department is related to the common goal, that should be there. Until and unless it is not there, then that is not a organization. So, which this I had already explained in my another session too. If you are interested, you can check that session. So, in this, organizations are either the open system approach and or the closed system approach. So, in case the open system and the closed system is, open system is basically which is openly interacting components are there, where I had already discussed about people, task, technology and structure. So when the open interaction among these four is there of the human behavior, that is open, and internal components also interact with the components in the organization task environment, that becomes open. So open structure system organization, it consists of people, technology, structure and purpose all interact with each other in the open environment. Though vice versa in the closed means which not interact with that. If I give you the example of nuclear family and a close-knitted joint family, so that is the example. So in case of the open family, that is a nuclear family, and closed family is the your joint family who is not interested to interact with the outside culture or the new culture. They are not interested to get that kind of a culture in their family. So these are the two systems. So in case you may identify in the terms of the organizations that organizations in case of manufacturing the product like aircraft or steel or any other delivery services, right? For example, so in these the need is to identify the open system components and the components of the task environment to see that how the organization functions. So in this framework, to understand the organization, we have the four internal components, that is task, people, technology and structure. So when we have task, people, structure and technology, these we have, and these are the four internal major components, and these four components along with the organization input and output are there, and these key elements in the task environment is there. So this task environment is there, right? So people is basically, again, for this task environment, this whole structure is related to mission, related to main purpose or the goal of the organization. Now the people are the human resources of the organization, right? Their skill, their knowledge, their ability, each and everything is in the part of the organization. And your technology is the wide range of the tools, knowledge, techniques to transform your input to the output. Then is your structure. The structure is the system of the communication, system of authority, system of the workflow. So this is the part of this is basically the meaning of your structure. So these major internal components, the organization as a system has external task environment, and the task environment is composed of different constituents. So different constituents means, or if I say different stakeholders, though are supplier, customer and your government and so on, right? So these are your stakeholders. So where basically that these task environment as an element of environment related to the organization to attain the goal, right? If you take the example of your Pepsi or of your Coca-Cola, where the chief competitor of Coca-Cola is Pepsi, to the Pepsi, right? So the key element in the Pepsi is task environment, and Pepsi must develop business strategy approach which considers the actions and the activities of Coca-Cola. Right, so the organization system works like this, and by taking the input and convert them input with the help of certain techniques and the technologies, and get the आउटपुट बेसिकली, और आउटपुट अगेन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ, द आउटपुट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द क्वालिटी, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सर्विसेज, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द गुड डिलीवरी टाइम, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द गुड यू नो रीपेमेंट, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बोनस एट्सेट्रा. सो दो द मटीरियल्स एंड द रिसोर्सेज ट्रांसफॉर्म बाय द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टेक्नोलॉजी कॉम्पोनेंट इज देयर. वंस दिस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन इज कंप्लीटेड, योर आउटपुट यू विल गेट रिलीज्ड एंड दैट इज डेफिनेटली गिवन टू योर stakeholders, either your consumer, either your shareholder who invested the money in your organization and get the return in the form of profit or in the form of bonus or in the form of some extra shares, bonus shares, right? And in the so on. So this is very important to understand that how the high quality, or you may say how the high quality output he or she may get, means your consumer may get. Again, here we are talking about the stakeholders. Now is the formal and the informal structures or the organizations. So these are the two kinds of the organizations. The organizations are the two form of the organizations. The formal is the officially set up organizations, and informal is which is not officially, means under the rules and regulations, which is not actually set up. Formally is officially legitimate, which we can say more visible, and you know, which is with the legal, logical, rational, and legal rule regulations are there, where you can sue and be sued, you can claim also. Informal is somehow which is nothing to do with the legitimate or the legal conditions, which is purely informal, which is on the basis of your perceptions, values and beliefs. If I say I have created some club, right, golf club, or if I have created some kitty party, so in that way, right, or in if I say that some club of dance club I have created, that is purely informal. But if it is regulated by some government regulation or by the state government regulation, that becomes the formal, where the job descriptions are there, authority is there, structure is there, legal foundations are there, legitimate it is, purely union and management, you know, the relation is there. Goals and objectives, policies and procedures, all are related. So then that become purely formal. So it is very important to understand, in case of the organizations where the employee-employer relationship is there, which is properly legitimate, which can be sued and be sued, that is purely defined, that is formal organization. And in case of the informal, means in the formal, we may have informal like friend circle, like friends group, or a friends club. So Facebook, for example, if I say, that is again informal, right? So these things are, there is a difference among both these two, and it is very important to find out. And if anyone asks you that do I can found the informal organization in formal, so yes, very right, you can found the informal organization in the formal organization, because where you are in the official relation, you may find the moods and emotions of the employees that may affect to the organization outcome, or to the decision making, or to the creativity, or to the teamwork, leadership. So that's why it is said that informal organization always exists within the formal organization, and it is very important to control the formal organization with the help of the informal organization. So if I talk about the informal, that informal elements are important, because people feeling, people thoughts, attitudes are very important. For example, say in case organization is interested to change the policy or to go ahead for merger, amalgamation, acquisition, so these organizations play a vital role, just with a view to convey them about this this decision, to find out whatever their decisions, their feelings, their thoughts, their doubts, their attitude is there, so that we can clarify that their emotions and their moods, and on the basis of that, so that in future we won't face any sort of a problem in the formal organization, in their job performance, in their decision making, and to ensure the integrity and negotiation, leadership and teamwork in the formal organization. So these are for such kind of decisions, these are really, really beneficial, and definitely no doubt to maintain the, you know, the goodwill of the organization too, these organizations play vital role. Thank you for now, and in the next session I will discuss about how to conduct the discipline and rest of the things. And in case of any question, please ask me. I hope it is clear. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.